Let's start the new topic, LC oscillation. So in this particular article, we will study a circuit made up of only inductor L and capacitor C, and we will arrange this circuit in such a way that the two ends of a charged capacitor that is capital C. So these two ends are connected by a conductor or resistor. And so, by arranging this circuit in this way, the capacitor will be discharged and the energy which was stored in the capacitor, means energy of capacitor, will now be dissipated in the form of the electric current, or we can say joule heat. And such kind of arrangement is shown in the figure below. So here, as you are watching that, the capacitor and its two ends are connected with the inductor L. Now, if such kind of arrangement is done, then what happens when the two plates of charged capacitor are connected with the inductor L? So the general case are we now consider for this inductor L. And this inductor L is having one property that it has low resistance, or you can neglect it. This low resistance is of the form of negligated, means R is equal to 0. Then such a circuit is known as only LC circuit. Because it consists of only inductor L and capacitor C. And in addition to that, the AC voltage supply is also eliminated from the circuit, and hence it is only known as LC circuit. And here we have not written the word alternating current because no kind of AC voltage is flowing through the circuit. And one more thing which you should notice over here, that the polarity, the positive charge of capacitor plate is connected with the positive charge of inductor, and here the negative plate is also connected with the negative end of indicator. If you have exchanged the sign, then in the both side you have to exchange, otherwise the mask will be cut. Now starting with the initial time, means at time t is equal to 0, the charge on the capacitor is written as Q subscript 0, and the current in this circuit is also 0. So here two things are now determined. Here we should assume that the capacitor is brought in the circuit at this particular time. And now, the moment at which inductor is joined to the circuit, then when L is joined, so at this particular time, the charge on capacitor will start to decreasing, because this charge will be converted into the form of joule heat. And so, suppose I am consider the another case of time interval t is equal to t, the charge on the capacitor is capital Q and the current in the circuit is capital I, which was 0 at time t is equal to 0. And here, we will now apply Kirchhoff's second law to the circuit, to the LC circuit particularly, at time t is equal to t. Then we will get, see, first of all, the current which is passing through the inductor L, that is given by minus L di by dt plus Q by C, that is equal to 0, which is the Kirchhoff's second law. Here why should have write 0? Because there is no AC voltage or particularly AC supply voltage is applied to this LC circuit, and here this equation is come from the charge is equal to capacitance into voltage, and so this is the voltage across capacitor and this is the voltage across the inductor L. And now after simplifying the result, we have the equation of electric current I, that means the rate of change of current in the capacitor. So it is dq by dt, which is equation number 2. But here you should understand one thing, that the capacitor or the charge on the capacitor is keep on decreasing. So here we have to add the negative rate. And hence, substitute equation number 2 in equation 1, we will get one differential equation. Therefore, minus L d square Q by dt square plus Q by C is equal to 0. So, this is actually the second order differential equation in terms of charge Q, which is total charge. Now, we will take this d square q by dt square on one side, or we will make this d square q over dt square as an object. Therefore, minus L d square q by dt square is equal to minus q by c. And here, if you look at this equation, then there will be not negative sign, but it will be a positive sign. So, plus L d square q by dt square plus q by c, that is equal to 0. And now I am taking this L d square q by dt square on one side. And therefore, L d square q by dt square is equal to minus q over c. Therefore, d square q by dt square is equal to minus q over lc. That is equation number 3. So, this equation is similar to the differential equation of the form of d square y by dt square is equal to minus omega 0 square y. So, equation number 3 and 4 are comparable, where the equation number 4 is of the simple harmonic motion. And here, the differential equation what we have obtained is for electronical AC, LC circuit. And so, what kind of observation you can say in terms of this equation is similar to the simple harmonic motion? So, by comparing, the charge Q is playing the same role as the displacement is playing in simple harmonic motion, and 1 upon LC is playing the same role as omega 0 square is playing in the case of simple harmonic motion. So, the solution of equation 3 can be given in terms of Q is equal to Qm sine omega 0 t plus phi. Now, after writing this solution, it is necessary that you should determine all the terms. So, what is the Qm? Here, Qm and phi are the constants of the solution, and we can determine such constant by improvising the initial and final condition. And omega 0 is the angular frequency, and at time t is equal to t, we have started our analysis, so it will be as it is. So now, in order to find out Qm and phi, I consider one case at time t is equal to 0. The charge was Q is equal to Q0. And so, substitute this value in equation 5. What you will get? So, Q is equal to Qm sine phi, because T is equal to 0. Now, if you differentiate the second number of equation, or this particular equation, say equation number 5, suppose you differentiate, then you will get the value of electric current I is equal to dq by dt. That is equal to d by dt. And the value of equation 5 I am putting over here. So, the value of equation 5 is Qm sine omega 0 t plus phi. And we will now differentiate the equation, but Qm is constant, so I can take it outside from the differentiation. Therefore, the value of electric current I is equal to Qm cos omega 0 t plus phi, and the differentiation of omega 0 t is only omega 0. So, this is my equation number 6. And so, at time t is equal to 0, I was also 0. the electric current passing through the circuit was zero. And with this equation, you can say that therefore Qm omega 0 cos phi is equal to 0. But remember, the value of Qm and the value of omega is not equal to 0. So it is depending upon this constant, or we can say the phase phi. So whenever the value of phi is equal to pi by 2, then and then cos phi is equal to 0. And so I am substituting this value of phi in one important equation. What we have obtained, Q is equal to Qm sin phi is equal to Qm sin pi by 2, and sin pi by 2 is 1. So here Q is equal to Qm, that is the maximum value of charge that is stored on the plates of capacitor. Now if we use the solution of the equation or the angle, then the actual equation was Q is equal to Qm sin omega 0 t plus phi. But the value of Qm is now Q0. Here Q0 will become. And the value of phi is we have earlier obtained, that is pi by 2. So Qm is equal to Q0 into sine omega 0 t plus pi by 2. That is equal to now sine pi by 2 plus theta. So let's understand the quadrant first. So from 0 to pi by 2, there will be first quadrant. From pi by 2 to pi, there will be the second quadrant. And here pi by 2 plus this much value. So this function will lie in the second quadrant. And in the second quadrant, the value of sine function is positive. And therefore, Q is equal to Q0 cos omega 0 t. And this equation shows that the charge on the capacitor changes periodically. And if you want to find out the electric current or the nature of electric current, then you just have to differentiate this equation with respect to time. So it is equal to d by dt Q0 cos omega 0 t. But in this particular case, the charge is constant with respect to time, but actually it is not. And so the initial charge at time t is equal to 0, that I can consider as constant. So Q0 is outside the integration. Now the differentiation of cos omega 0 t, so it is minus sine omega 0 t. And now the differentiation of inner part, that means omega 0 t, that will be omega 0, and hence I is equal to minus Q0 omega 0 sine omega 0 t. So here the charge and current both are changing periodically. So as this current and charge are changing periodically, so we can say that there is a nature of oscillation type. And so by giving some observation, at last we will prove that the motion in the LC circuit are in the form of oscillation. So my first observation, I am starting at time t is equal to 0. At time t is equal to 0, if you remember, the inductor was not connected. And so at that time, the value of charge at the capacitor plate, there will be maximum. And so the current in the inductor, means IL, will be 0. So in this case, the intensity of electric field, if you remember some equation, intensity of electric field produced between the plates of capacitor is given by the maximum values. So at time t is equals to 0, these three observations have been made, and also the energy which is stored at the capacitor, and this energy is also related to electric field. So as the electric field is maximum, so energy stored will be also maximum. And this energy is given by a potential kind of energy, 1 by 2 Q square over C, because the actual equation is Q into V by 2. But here the value of V is given by Q over C. And so the potential energy is given by 1 by 2 Q square over C. And here, as the current in the inductor is 0, then the magnetic field associated with the inductor is also 0, and so no energy is associated with inductor. See, whenever I am writing a simple E without vector notation, then you should have to consider it as energy, not as electric field, because electric field is containing vector quantity. Otherwise, you can only understand about its magnitude, not about its direction. And thus, the energy stored in the electric field of a capacitor is transformed, or it is converted into the energy stored in the magnetic field of inductor. So here I am writing in this way. The energy stored in the magnetic field of inductor, because here initially the magnetic field of the inductor was 0, and so there was no energy was stored. But after the connection of inductor, when the charge on the capacitor is keep on decreasing, then the energy stored in the inductor will keep on increasing. And so here we can consider the law of parallel connection of resistance. In that case, the capacitor or the value of energy was inversely proportional to the resultant resistance. Now, when the charge on the capacitor, means QC, will become 0, then current I of the inductor, means IL, that will be maximum. At this time, the total energy stored in the electric field is now completely transformed into a magnetic field. And so now the energy stored in the electric field is now zero, but the energy stored in the magnetic field is the maximum. And this process is continuously repeating, because when now the energy stored in the electric field is zero, so the energy in the magnetic field will provide some way to increase the energy in the electric field. So, here the electric charge oscillates between the two plates of the capacitor via inductor. So the oscillation of electric charge, we can assume over here that it is between the two plates of capacitor, but it is going in between the path of inductor. So this phenomenon is called the oscillation in LC circuit. Or you can also consider this as, or this phenomenon as, LC oscillation. And one more thing, that this LC circuit is also known as tank circuit. And if the energy is provided in the LC circuit, equals the energy emitted, equals to the energy emitted, then what happens? Then the continuous emission of the electromagnetic wave is obtained, because whenever the energy in the electric field is zero, then energy which is stored in magnetic field is giving some amount of energy to the electric field, and vice versa. When the energy stored in the magnetic field is zero, then the LC oscillations are providing in this way. Energy stored in the electric field will give the energy stored in the magnetic field.